full hilaire.
Problems running deep.
It's hard to think of a man who is made, at least in part, of steel as a poet. And perhaps it would embarrass him to be called one. But listen for yourself as Evel reveals his creative side.
This poem that I wrote came about. I was in Chicago for a show at the Navy Pier. And it was after I had been hurt so badly in Las Vegas and had just got back on crutches and was able to walk, and I weighed about 130, 135 pounds. And I remember they'd take me over there and they'd stand me up and they'd say, show the film of him jumping. They'd show the film and I'd stand there by my motorcycle and everybody come up and look at me. I wasn't very well known then by a lot of people. And they'd say, why do you do it? What's the matter with you? Why do you keep on doing it? And I, you know, I'd say, well, you know, money's good or this, that, or I didn't know how to answer them, really. I got so tired of getting asked why, I didn't know what the hell I was doing. I was on my way back to Los Angeles to perform for a man named Al Dobrich, who had the Dobrich International Circus at the time, and I was trying to get stronger so I could perform for him. And I remember when I was coming back across Texas, I think it was, and I had what they call an Oldsmobile Vista Cruiser station wagon. It had a glass top. And I was really delirious, almost to a point that my temperature was so high, and I was laying in the back of it, and I was looking out through this glass top, and I got to thinking about the question why that people asked me. And I said to Ray, I said, give me a notepad. Well, I was concerning writing a song, but I couldn't carry a tune in a bucket, so I wrote this poem, and I wrote it in a matter of an hour or 2 hours. Just before it got daylight, it was done. And I think that it answers the question for every man and woman on the face of this earth at the end of it, why you do what you do and why I do what I do in life. And it's a very simple thing. And the poem goes like this. I'll do it for you. It seems that everywhere in this world I go, no matter who or what I know, the people, they look, and most of them stare, and I wonder if they really care. You see this cane with its golden crown? Some of them smile, but most of them frown. I hear them laugh, and I see them cry. No matter what, they all ask why. Why? Well, I'm just like you, and you, and you, and your wife. We all have a special purpose in life. And my way of life, I'm glad that I found, for like you, I too make the world go round. We're all alike. Oh, yes, we are. We all have a dream on some faraway star. For me, when it's over and done at the end of a day, my men go to relax, but I go to pray. For I know that tomorrow, in some other place, I'll have that jump again to face. Each time I was hurt, they all said, that guy is lucky that he's not dead. And they were right. But I wanted to get up, to try it again. I kept telling myself that I knew I could win. So I'd close my eyes, and to the Lord I would pray. Oh, help me, God. Let me walk someday. And he did. And every stitch on every scar has just brought me closer to my dream afar. To be a man and to do my best, to stand alone is my only quest. Success is a term that has broad use. For you and I to have none in life, there's no excuse. For you to do what I do is not right. But for me, it's not wrong. What I've been trying to tell you all along is that it's got to be. So, if you wonder why, the answer to that is that just like you, I've got to be me.